Christian team. I think you don't need to settle. You need to try to get to the free throw line. Last year, the Red Raiders in this building were 7 of 21 from the stripe. Need to do a better job with that tonight. You do have a size advantage. Mr. Friday is 6'9", about 230, but you do have a size advantage with this team. You own the glass. I think your post defense versus Jelani Friday as well, because I think Brian Berg, as you heard him say, they lead the country in deep post touches, so you got to make sure the help is coming, know where it's coming from and all that. And to me, here's a wild card. We need to get Brandon Francis going. You know, it's been a little bit. He's still facilitating and doing some good things for his basketball team. Need to get him going and scoring a little bit. I'm looking for that, because guess what? You might need him Thursday night in MSG.
21 assists to 5 turnovers. That goes to your facilitating comment, because that stood out to me. That jumped up and grabbed me today, the 21 to 5 and the assists for Brandon Francis. But only 5.7 points. It'd be nice for him to get up around double figures. We'll see if he can do it.
And the last time you and I sat together in Miami, he hit some big shots at the end of that game at the top of the key from behind the arc.
On the court, it's the job of the defense to protect the rim. On the road, it's the job of the 2019 Nissan Rogue to help protect you. With its available advanced safety technologies, Nissan. Tip-off coming up next between Texas Tech and Abilene Christian, live at the Coliseum on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield. That's first.
It's not even 6 yet. This contest with the Red Raiders down 3-0. Our apologies as they started 2 minutes early, and Matt Mooney misses a little floater in the lane. Left to right, here come the Wildcats. Abilene Christian in purple, their retro uniforms. This is caught by Trey Lennox. He'll jab left, take a step right, and throw it into the post. The face up for Jaron Lewis. Lewis going to shoot it from 10. Short rebound for Norris Odiasse of Texas Tech. 3-0 Abilene Christian as Jarrett Culver slashes to the goal. He got to the window, dunked it, and a foul.
That'll work right there. You missed open looks right there, and then Culver just says, you know what, top of the key. Let's see what ACU can do trying to guard me going to the rim, and the answer is they could not. Brandon Francis already about to come into this game. We're a minute and a half in.
Red Raider basketball games mean roaring fans, good friends, and favorite game day grub from United Supermarkets. Get all your courtside essentials at United Supermarkets. Free throw up and good by Jarrett Culver, who's sitting at 68% from the line. And here come the Wildcats, left to right. The Red Raiders and the Cats tied at three, even though the scoreboard said 4-3. Left wing, Jaron Lewis throws it out top for Jelani Friday. Friday hit the three, by the way, when we were just coming here live. That's Peyton Ricks sharing out front with eight on the shot clock. There's a drive by Moretti and a foul on Davide and a basket. Boy, a strong move by Jalen Franklin and one.
Yeah, it hacks for, you know, basically ACU just spread the floor out, and Franklin just took Moretti one-on-one right there, and just, you know, Moretti just kind of bailed him out right there. Didn't have much of a chance. Help side defense not there quick enough.
2 minutes gone as Franklin toes the line. He gets there, tied for first, 30 attempts, 63% free throw shooter, and he makes. Hit the rim, bounced up, rattled around, and dropped. 6-3 on that three-point play, Abilene Christian. They show a 1-2-2 press that's navigated with several passes by Davide Moretti. Moretti gets it over for Jarrett Culver, 17:50 left to play in the first half. Culver, two bounces, a whistle and a foul away from the ball against Abilene Christian. And that's on Jelani Friday, his first. He's coming off of 19 points against the Campbell Camels.
Yeah, you know, if you want to get somebody in foul trouble for ACU, Friday
he's
is
it?
The one. Yeah, I would say so. Jaron Lewis is going to be the other one. It's just the team runs through both of those guys. Jalen Franklin does a good job. Peyton Ricks does a good job. But I think Friday and Lewis are certainly where it's at.
B.J. Maxwell is in. He is a junior from Austin, 6'5". Kyler Edwards tiptoes to the top. He just checked in. A double team run, so he throws it to Mooney. Mooney tried to alley-oop, but it was tipped away and stolen by Abilene Christian. Then taken by Mooney, who reverses it up and in.
That's just all Matt Mooney right there, Hacks. He got that lob tipped away right there and then just stole it back. He got taken out about a minute and a half in a while ago, and he wasn't happy about that. So clearly some motivation right there for number 13 in white.
Quick fire three on the right wing is strong by Peyton Ricks. Loose ball out of bounds off of Tariq Owens. Our officials are Paul Jansen, Roderick Dixon, and John Stigliano. 17:15 left to play in the first half. 6-5 Abilene Christian. We're courtside here at the Coliseum that is almost to capacity as we speak. Right wing, Maxwell. Right corner now in front of Chris Beard. Loping out front is Ricks, tracked by Jarrett Culver and the man-to-man. They're wanting to throw it into the post. There it goes for Hayden Farquhar. Left corner three, Maxwell. Flat, short, rebound on a hop. It's taken by Brandon Francis, and in white and the retros for Texas Tech. Kyler Edwards skates to the rack. Layup missed. Tap no. Loose ball. Foul against Texas Tech. Lawrence Odiasse will check back in after the personal foul. Level, did you catch who it was on?
No, we are down low here. Not a great view. They have not attached a foul to anybody.
You can't post it up here on the scoreboard.
Yeah, it's going to go on. It was Kyler Edwards.
Thank you very much.
Yes,
Kyler
sir.
Edwards first. Kyler coming off of 7 points against Northwestern State. Boy, the Cats really driving it here. It says Cats in cursive writing across the front of the jersey tops. There's a shot over Brandon Francis that rolled around and popped out from Jaron Lewis. A diving attempt, and it results in a steal by Norris Odiasse, and he got fouled by Jaron Lewis. What a hustle play.
Boy, and I got to tell you, ACU sets are really good. I mean, they do. They get the ball with those deep post touches, and it's basically just very good offense, creating mismatches, cutting through the lane right there. But that ball almost went in. Three Red Raiders surrounded it. You finally get a foul called on them.
Moretti, Edwards, Odiasse, Deshaun Corpru, and Matt Mooney on the floor for the Red Raiders. Black numerals trimmed in red, white uniforms, Texas Tech in black. Left wing Mooney draws defenders. Out it goes for Deshaun Corpru. Right wing three in the air by Edwards. Bang! A guns up three ball for Kyler. His ninth three of the year.
So much more confidence. here we are near Christmas time, and he's starting to feel it, though, and understand what it takes to play at this level.
8-6 Red Raiders. First lead of the afternoon turning evening here in Lubbock for Tech. Maxwell is guarded by Corpru. Rips and takes it to the top. Deshaun tracking his every moment. Maxwell still with the bounce. 10 on the shot clock. Down to the left block and rifled out front to the double T. Right wing hesitation drive. Ricks pops it up from 8. Air ball. Ripping it out of the air. Deshaun Corpru. The Red Raiders counter with Edwards. Blowing by one defender. Crossing to the middle. Firing to the right side. 3 by Moretti. Halfway down and out. Flat-footed rebound by Maxwell of Abilene Christian. Farquhar looks at 3 at the top. That's not his game. Farquhar just kind of a screener. Going to drive it at Norris Odiasse and leave it left corner with 15:25 left in the first half. 8-6 Red Raiders. Out it goes for Jalen Franklin. Look at him. He wants to go downhill. He blazes off the screen. Pulls up from 17. Back rim high in the air. Corpru rips it down with the right hand. 15:10 left in the first half. Corpru running away from a double team. He fires it to the high post for Odiasse. Nice find for Mooney. And it's stuffed up into the rim and backboard, and it'll stay there.
And Chris Beard basically telling Matt Mooney, shot fake right there, young fella.
Shot faking is over.
Yes, shot fake. You get him up in the air, you might get an and one opportunity.
So on the jump ball, it'll be Abilene Christian's ball when we come back.
Intense here early on. I mean, this
Absolutely.
Is up and down. Intense.
Before we hit the break, let's pause for station identification. You're listening to Red Raider Basketball.
Master Cleaners is a proud partner of Texas Tech Athletics. And with the Wells Fargo Texas Tech debit card, you can show your Red Raider pride with every purchase you make. Head to the local Wells Fargo and make and ask for your new Red Raider debit card today. Wells Fargo is a proud sponsor of Texas Tech Athletics.
It's 8-6 Texas Tech, 15:03 left to play in the first half. Level intensity marking this one. Abilene Christian certainly looks the part.
Oh, there's no question. And again, as we talked about, come in with a lot of confidence at 9-1.
Running into a double team is Joe Pleasant, and a foul against Tech. They got too close, and Matt Mooney picked up the foul as first. Abilene Christian, no points in the last 3:09. They are 0 for their last 5 from the field. Inbounds goes to Jalen Franklin. He is a powerful, strong point guard. They got a box set along the lane, going to set screens as it's handed off back to Baxter. Right corner 3 by Farquhar. Left it short. Flat-footed rebound for Jarrett Culver, who triggers the break with Moretti. Davide backs up on the right sideline. 14:30 left to play in the first half. Texas Tech leading Abilene Christian 8-6. Mooney goes point right for Jarrett Culver. Forgot about the ball for a moment, picked it up. Corprew lines up a left wing three, halfway down and out, and I mean around down and out. Rebound, Abilene Christian.
And boy, I tell you what, nobody's shooting it better right now than Deshaun Corprew. And if you look around at the stands right now, there are not many empty seats at all. This thing is close to capacity.
Corprew 50% from three, 64% from the field. 12 on the shot clock, 14 on the big clock. Baseline right, it's a catch by Franklin. 7-6, hands it to Farquhar. He's got to shoot it for three, he does. He was open, he clanged it short. Mooney with a box out rebound and a foul against Baxter. Excuse me, Maxwell.
Yeah, it's just a good box out by Matt, as you talked about. He had him dead to rights, and you know, you leave your feet, come over the back right there. That's an easy call for the official on B.J. Maxwell.
13:50 left to play in this first half. Near capacity crowd. It's going to be capacity. There's, like Level said, there's just a few red chair backs yet to be had in the far end zones.
Yeah, and Hax, this start feels much like last year. Just shots not falling, no flow just yet for the Red Raiders on offense.
Two threes go halfway down and out.
And I mean, just buried shots that are just not quite falling in. But it was just, I remember last year in here, just a bit of a grind.
The lineup on the floor is Owens, Mooney, Moretti, Culver, and Brandon Francis. Mooney jogs it across with the left hand, switches to the right. Baseball's a pass to Moretti, who will drive right baseline. Up fake several times, nothing available. Coach Beard wants motion after the set play didn't work. Culver catches, guarded closely by Trey Lennox. Tries to go left, two defenders run at him, and then Lennox fouled him. Maybe a little bailout there, Level, for Culver, who had to desperately drive it to the hoop.
Yeah, he got double teamed out there in the perimeter. Trey Lennox picks up a cheap one. You're right, shot clock kind of dripping down right there. And
it's a good way to describe it, dripping down. Damian Daniels is a freshman, 5'7", 140. Little guy from Kansas City. Tech leads 8-6 as Mooney shakes his man, passes right corner. Jared Culver backing in, couldn't get it going. Shot clock's at 11, so he'll fire it up for a long two, or is it a three? It's a two. He nailed it. Jared Culver's got five.
And as you mentioned, that wasn't necessarily in the flow of the offense right there, but he pulls the trigger and foot basically on the line right there over there in the corner.
Nearly 7 minutes gone in the first half. Tech leads 10-6. Drive, jump pass, left corner. Touched out for the little guy. Damian Daniel, straight on three. Good. Buried by Jelani Friday. His 13th three of the season. He shoots at 34% from out there.
And that's 6'9", 230 pounds out there pulling the trigger on the three-point line.
Without hesitation.
Absolutely.
12:45 left in the first half. Red Raiders lead 10-9. Coming off a down screen as Davide Moretti finds Culver in the post. He went up for the follow away and went down awkwardly. He got pushed. I think he'll get two free throws. That is Peyton Ricks, who hit four threes against Campbell. He picks up his first foul.
You know, in the last big that the Red Raiders saw, this past week, Ishmael Lane, you know, he really struggled 0 for 11, and he could step out and knock it down. But Mr. Friday, certainly with a soft touch out there in every bit of 6'9", 235.
In 68 games, he has 921 points. As a Wildcat, catching at the top and driving, Culver hangs, shoots, rolls home, count the basket, he's fouled. He didn't get any free throws, but now he will. He'll get one.
And, you know, he settled for that jumper a while ago, which he buried, but that's the second or third time we've seen Jarrett not settle and with a shot fake and drive to the basket. Each time has resulted in a free throw attempt as well. So he's certainly feeling it early right now with 7 points and with a chance to go to 8.
Could be a big night for Culver. He already has 7 as he lines up the free throw and connects. He just looks calm and in his game. It's his 47th game as a Red Raider, his 11th start. Make it 30th start. Moretti has started 11. 12:23 left in the first half. Red Raiders lead 13-9 over Abilene Christian. Catching off the screen, scraping that way is Franklin. Checks over his right shoulder to 8th-year head coach Joe Golding. Good friends with Chris Beard. He's going to drive it, pitch it, open three, right corner. Halfway down, it rolled out by Jelani Friday. Boy, the Red Raiders dodged a bullet there, but they were due to have one miss like that. Left corner, dribble drive, Kyler Edwards bangs in, throws it out, right wing. Moretti got ripped and fouled as he tried to drive it. And we've got a media timeout. That's already 1-1 bonus time for the Red Raiders, for Davide Moretti when we come back.
game action, go to RedRaidersContest.com and register for your chance to be the guest coach for a day. Winners receive two courtside seats, a pregame photo op, and more. Register today at RedRaidersContest.com. Texas Farm Bureau Insurance, proud sponsor of Texas Tech Athletics.
Red Raiders lead 13-9 with 11:57 left to play in the first half. Congratulations to Marlene Stallings and the Lady Raiders. They defeat Nevada today 86-67. It's the first non-conference road win in 6 years for Texas Tech basketball. Congratulations to them. They really blew out Nevada in their own building. That was cool to see, Level.
Yeah, I really like what she's doing. I mean, clearly has a plan and likes that up-tempo style, likes to shoot the three, and her teams are going to run up down the floor. It's fun to watch.
Moretti cans the first, so he'll get another. Moretti is 18 of 19 from the free throw stripe this season. Doesn't miss very often. One of the best free throw shooters in the country, wears the number 25 on the back of his jersey as he pushes that one up high and makes it. That relieves me because I thought I was really going to jinx him there, Level, but he made it.
Yeah, and it's like seeing Bigfoot whenever you see Moretti miss a free throw.
Yeah.
And it hadn't happened much.
There's not an empty seat in the house. 11:47 left to play in the first half. 15-9 Texas Tech.
It's pretty much full. You're right. And there's
Red
people
Raiders
standing.
In a zone defense here? Yeah, it's a 3-2 zone. Oh, a little chess match between the old buddies. Left corner catch. Owens is all over him. Mooney got a hand on the pass. Almost a double dribble for Trey Lennox. That's a left-handed three that hit the backboard first for Damian Daniels. He almost put that one in the cheerleaders' laps. The Red Raiders have it right to left with Jared Culver leaping to pass left corner. Mooney squeezes off a three. Bang! A moonshot. Timeout. Abilene Christian.
Yeah,
18-9 Red Raiders.
Matt had those three makes the other night versus Northwestern State. Got him going a little bit. Nice to see that one fall in for him right there as the Red Raiders have doubled up the Wildcats from Abilene.
Fans ever wonder what the most comfortable pillow feels like? Go to MyPillow.com, click on the four-pack special, and enter promo code REDRAIDERS to find out. You'll get two premium pillows and two go-anywhere pillows for 50% off when you use promo code REDRAIDERS. Jeff Haxton, Chris Level, and Maurice Jones, our producer-engineer back in Jefferson City. Want to say hello to Russell listening in St. Louis and Melissa listening in Pflugerville. Melissa and Benji right into us at Guns Up Radio on the Twitter machine. At Guns Up Radio is the way to get that done. It's quite a night in the Coliseum.
Oh, I mean, it is packed. I mean, it is packed. Talk about the old days. This is like 95, 96.
2-2-1, kind of soft press here. Really not looking to get the steal, just to slow the Wildcats down. They've got cats in cursive across the front of the jersey tops as it goes right corner for Trey Lennox. And a whistle and a foul on Tariq Owens underneath. Chris Beard doesn't like the call from John Stigliano. He said that was good basketball. You probably heard it down the line.
I strongly disagree with that call. He's saying that that Tariq's knee is in Friday's kind of back or whatever. They're simply banging around back there. And if you can't play post defense like that, I mean, I don't know what you're supposed to do.
Friday catches the inbounds, pushed off of Tariq Owens, it looked like, and then put in about a 10-footer. Backing down, Jarrett Culver goes to his right, shooting hand, got fouled. Count the basket for Jarrett Culver. His third opportunity at an and one.
That's a young man that's looking to have a big night right now. He's got 10 points, and I don't want to jinx his line right now. But it looks pretty good.
There's some perfection in there.
Yeah, that's right.
He's shooting on the basket to our left. And he missed it short.
Well, we should have just called it out.
We'll share blame.
Yeah, that's right.
That's the 30th double-figure game already for Jarrett Culver in his young career. His 10th this season. If you know our record, he's been in double figures every time. 20-11, Red Raiders with 10:23 left as they funnel a pass that's ripped away by Mooney. Loose ball. They're diving on it. Grabbing it in traffic is Brandon Francis. And now streaking sideline right is Jarrett Culver, lining up his defender, crosses to the right baseline. Hands it for Mooney, layup, good. Oh, that was sweet.
See, and that's Jarrett Culver facilitating right now. We've seen him be aggressive, hunting for his shot. That's him facilitating right there.
Fall away jumper Friday, yes. He looks like a pro. Jelani Friday on the right baseline. Cash money. 22-13 Red Raiders, 9:50 left to play in the first half. Edwards looks at a man-to-man Wildcat defense, finds Culver. Culver dances to his right, back to his left, looks at a three instead out to Francis. There's a backdoor cut and a catch by Culver. Falls away, off the glass and in for Jarrett Culver. Assist from B. Fran.
Well, I mean, and Culver's got 12. Friday has 10. There's been 37 points scored in this game, and they've got, 23 of them.
There's a backdoor pass and catch and layup for Jaron Lewis. He's benefiting from Friday's success, and the other players like Mooney benefiting from Culver's success. 24-15 Red Raiders, 9:12 left to play in the first half. Mooney foul line right extended. Jabs, runs into a hedge, was a big hedge from Friday. Mooney got battered around and fouled by Peyton Ricks. That's his second, and it'll be a 1-1 for Matt Mooney.
And Coach Golding wants to travel, but he completely got Francis right there on the elbow at the, over there on the wing. That's just a bad foul right there by Mr. Ricks.
Coach Golding with that kind of death stare down this way as he's looking at the personnel being issued in and out.
He's trying to find 10 fouls to 4 is what he's saying. Yeah, and he's
free throw missed. It's a double bonus. Matt Mooney missed it. Mooney is a 71% free throw shooter. Gets there second most, made the second most.
And Hacks, I mean, wasn't he about 87% in South Dakota last year?
Yes.
You know, and that's been a surprise. I tell you, the two things about his game that have surprised me the most is he hadn't shot the free throws as well as I thought, but he also sees the floor and his
so
assists.
Well.
Yes, he facilitates so much better than I would have thought.
He leads the team in steals as Friday drops a little pass inside, a back down and a foul. You heard it from here, and count the basket for Jaron Lewis. Abilene Christian is so far beyond anything we've seen at the USA. As far as those competitions that we've had, the six matches over there, you saw every one of them. They're so far past anybody that we've seen.
Yeah, I think that's fair. When Coach Beard said it the other day, I mean, this is the best team we'll have seen at home. And I think he actually said this may be the best team other than Nebraska that have been on the Red Raiders schedule. And that includes Memphis. That includes USC.
I think Tech's playing some good ball so far. Red Raiders shooting at 60%. Completing the and one is Jaron Lewis, a 63% free throw shooter, made it. He's got five, 25-18 Texas Tech, 8:45 left in the first half. Raider Red looking on as we are to the basket to our left as Moretti snakes a bounce pass to Jarrett Culver. Culver wearing the left wristband, lobs it left corner for Deshaun Corcoran. In front of the ACU bench, there's 10 on the shot clock. Out to the middle for Davide Moretti. Left wing Mooney, five. He's going to catapult it for three. Hit the front, popped over. Weak side rebound for Abilene Christian. Ripping it down, Joe Pleasant, whose father played in the NFL. He's got that kind of body from Overland Park, Kansas. A freshman, doesn't look like it. Trying to drive Jalen Franklin. He's repelled. Man-to-man defense for the Red Raiders. Left corner, open three. Lennox hit it. Trey Lennox.
Boy, and that's ACU's five of their last five there, Hacks. That's a 6-0 run, but that's less than a minute. So they've really cut into this lead, just a four-point lead by the Red Raiders.
Lob pass mid-post caught by Norris Odiasse. Back out to Moretti. Straight on for Corpru, who's going to drive it with his left hand. Has to back out. Shot clock's at 10. 7:40 on the game clock. Red Raiders lead 25-21. Corpru met with five. Tiptoes, accelerates down the lane. The floater, good. Deshaun Corpru with a big basket.
Yeah, that zone defense is starting to give the Red Raiders problems. It's kind of slowed them down a little bit as you see that shot clock starting to be an issue every time down.
That time he got in the middle of it and kind of blew it up from the inside. 7:17.
He just blows everything up.
He is.
Big fan of that kid, man.
He's the pit bull. He's that junkyard dog. 10 on the shot clock, and it's a stationary dribble. ACC down the side of the shorts for Abilene Christian. There's a push off and a foul. Matt Mooney takes the charge. Foul on Jalen Franklin.
Yeah, Coach Golding out on the floor, smiling. He said something we can't repeat now, but he did not.
Mince words?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Matt Mooney, though, took the charge right there out there in front of everybody for everybody to see. Nice job. Basically creates a turnover. For his team, gets the team ball back.
7:04 left in the first half. We'll take a break.
Oh, okay. All right.
7:04 left to play in this first half.
Does it feel like the Red Raiders are basically shooting 60% from the field?
Not really.
No, and it's what's fascinating, too, is just one turnover in this game.
That's crazy.
You're shooting 60%, and yet you're only up 6 points.
I think you're playing pretty good basketball, but I think Abilene Christian has had some nice answers as well. But those are good numbers. Abilene Christian, 8 of 18 from the field. As Matt Mooney accepts it and looks at a purple-clad man-to-man defense. Right wing three, Moretti. Short and left. Corprew had a chance, and Jelani Friday just out-hustled everybody and grabbed it in the left corner. He saved it to Peyton Ricks. But Jelani Friday could play anywhere. 6:43 left to play in the first half. Red Raiders by 6. Point right, Franklin. Reversed around to the left side. Grabbed by Trey Lennox, who has a 3 in this game. Left corner, Mooney guarding his man closely. He's going to drive, hang, tough pass. Found by Lennox, who got away with a walk. Drive, sweeping in, missed the layup. Tapped up, hitting the rim was Norrence, but he guided the ball to Deshaun Corprew of Texas Tech. Davide Moretti had his pass deflected out of bounds by Trey Lennox. Tell you what, Trey Lennox is playing some ball now. He only averages 2.4 points. He's appeared in every game, only averages 14 minutes. He had 11-4 against the Campbell Camels. Davide Moretti directing traffic in front of a sold-out crowd at the Coliseum. Culver dribbles in, walled off, drops a dive, layup good, little turnaround over the left shoulder for Deshaun Corprew.
Yeah, when you penetrate the zone defense like that right there, and you're going to find some work in the short corner, and Corprew did a good job of finding space, and Culver found him.
Jalen Franklin out front for Jaron Lewis. He's the pivot man right back to the left side of where it came from. Post-entry pass, they love to do that. Ball stripped, but grabbed by Friday. Friday almost dragged his pivot foot. Now one dribble in the left corner for Lewis. Friday for 3, snaps it off strong. Loose ball, won by the Red Raiders and Deshaun Corprew. They want the Red Raiders to run. Here comes Matt Mooney doing just that. Secondary break leaves it back for Deshaun Corprew. 5:23 left to play in the first half. Tech leads 29-21.
And that's why you want to run, and you don't want them to get back and set up in that zone defense.
Culver misses a left corner 3. Offensive rebound, Corprew, stripped on his way back up. Loose ball, bodies everywhere, and a timeout by Norrence Odiase, who was able to cover it up with both elbows and keep it with Tech and a lot of the shot clock.
Yeah, 26 seconds left. Yeah, I think you know, Texas Tech wants to run when they have the opportunity, because the slower you go, it just allows that zone to set up back there, and that's not what you want by the Red Raiders. And I tell you what, if I was asking for something for Santa, you know, for this basketball team, it's for Morrow's shots to start going in from the perimeter. I mean, he's now 11 of 35 from
that
the season.
He's a lot better than that.
Yeah,
level.
And he is better than that. That's my point. I mean, it is better. The shot is a soft touch. He shoots it well. He shoots it when he's open. He doesn't force them. They're just not going in. He's 0 for 2 from the field tonight from behind the arc.
AT&T is a proud sponsor of Texas Tech Athletics. Stay connected all season long with AT&T. More for your thing. That's our thing. And Ryan from Waxahachie says, is that an actual air horn? Guns up.
Yes, and they actually have a container of them in case that one runs out of
yeah, they got
air,
multiple air horns.
Or whatever is in there to make it make it sound like it does. Yeah, there's like 6 of them just in case.
Richard says he's listening in from San Diego, and Rob also from Pflugerville. Pflugerville, a popular spot tonight, all riding into At Guns Up Radio. There's a little confusion.
I wonder what the last event that was in here that drew this many people.
I couldn't tell you.
I really don't know. Maybe a concert.
Like the Beatles are in town.
Yeah, I mean, something like that. But courtside seats are full. They're full in the end zones all the way to the top.
I guess Bruno Mars would be better right now, as there's a drive. Pass by Colbert. Fouled on the way up. Tariq Owens really got hit hard on the shoulder. He'll earn 2 free throws. And we haven't heard much from Tariq just yet.
I was thinking the same thing. He got that early personal foul right there in the post, but has not shot the ball yet tonight. He's going to get some free throw opportunities here. Not much else, though, from Tariq, but he will get going.
Foul was on Friday, his 2nd personal. Free throw up by Owens. Swish. Tariq Owens, a 68% free throw shooter, makes it. Texas Tech leads the all-time series with Abilene Christian 24-12, and they've won 11 in a row against ACU. 2nd free throw, perfect level. Boy, he looked comfortable there. 68% looked better than that.
Yeah, no doubt.
4:55 left to play in the first half. Tech leads 31-21. Jeff Haxton, Chris Lovell courtside in the old Coliseum. Top of the circle, Franklin bolts off the screen. Had a shot blocked, but earned a foul. He'll get two free throws. Jalen Franklin, just with reckless abandon, threw himself in there.
Yeah, they ran a high pick and roll right there and threw Morrow off offline and late rotation over there.
Foul was on Brandon Francis. That's his first. Two free throws for Jalen Franklin. He's one for one. And he missed. Rattled out. Great uniform game. I mean, this thing is such a great look from, again, we've really bragged on the fans filling up the stands, but this purple against this white and both out of the 50s, 60s, 70s, whatever kind of throwback you want to make it.
Well,
it looks so good together.
Describe the stripes on the shorts.
Yeah.
Like at the, because the both styles of shorts have the same look to it. And I got to tell you, I wish they'd bring that back because it looks so much better than what everybody wears these days.
Franklin missed both free throws. It's released in front of the ACU bench to Matt Mooney. Left corner, quick trigger three. Francis airballed it. Loose ball, though, won by Tariq Owens. And the shot clock did reset, and it shouldn't have.
And I can't figure out what's going on with Francis, like, offensively, though, because he just doesn't look as confident as we're used to seeing him.
He and Reddy are in the same boat a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, and that's an air ball right there from the corner from B. Francis. And last year at this time, he's hunting his shot. He's stepping up. He's knocking those down. It's just out of sorts right now. Chris Beard's got his arm around him right now in the huddle.
Yeah, a little love, a little it's okay love. You know, like, there should be about 12 on the shot clock. They're going to put 10 up there. Hurry into Sonic for the new steakhouse bacon cheeseburger and tots for $4.99. It's everything you love about a steakhouse except the valet. They are sorry they do not provide that service. Inbounds, Jarrett Koval, just 10, now 9. As Davide Moretti tiptoes left with the ball in his right hip pocket. Glances off the screen. Culver's going to drive, going to get it to the window. Hang, layup, good. Reverse layup, and one. His chance goes to 4 on and ones tonight.
Well, and I hope people are appreciating that because I thought he had no chance to finish at the rim. I tell you, I thought the ball was going to Francis in the corner. Is Francis is wide open. And
he
then
got that down to his knees.
Here it comes way out and then back up with the left hand. And that's why the NBA folks like Jarrett Culver so much. How about Chris Beard say that after the game the other night? Hey, folks, if you have a question for this guy,
you better ask it
because he may not be around here much longer.
He made the free throw.
Yeah.
He's got 4 and ones, and he's made 3 of the 4 free throws. 4 minutes left, first half. Tech 34, Abilene Christian 21. Red Raiders playing like the 11th-ranked team of the country with 9 on the shot clock. It's grabbed and thrown to the right corner. 3, Lennox buried it. Trey Lennox has 3s, 8 and 9 on the year here in the first half. 3:42 left to play in this first half. Texas Tech leading by 10. Backing out, it's Matt Mooney to the right hand. Gets it for Culver. Culver left corner. Jabbing at the defender. Baseballs it all the way to the other side. 3 by Francis. Short. Culver boxes out and rebounds. Well, he's being batted around, so he found Francis. Francis hangs. Double clutch missed. Tapped around, and it's Owens that was close to getting it, but Lennox made the rebound for Abilene Christian. Still do a media timeout with 3:13 left to play in the first half.
Well, that's 3 or 4 attempts right there at the rim by B. Francis, and Chris Beard turns around and says, get him out. So Deshaun Corporeau is going to enter the game here shortly for Brandon Francis. Just not his night so far.
How about Abilene Christian? They've let this thing run down to 7 before doing any offense. And Franklin drive, pitches left corner. There's a drive in, a layup missed. It couldn't connect. B.J. Maxwell, Tech rebounds with Matt Mooney. Mooney shoulder shakes, hands it off underneath to Jarrett Culver, who spins. Yeah, you can't flop like that. Layup good. Jarrett Culver's got 17.
I mean, this is as good as we've seen him all season, Max. I mean, this is, he's putting on a clinic on the offensive end. It's inside, it's outside, he's driving, he's shooting it, he's sharing the basketball. Fun to watch.
Farquhar tried to back in. He's trapped at the left post area, the left elbow. Franklin gets instructions at the double T with 10 on the shot clock. Red Raiders lead it by 12. Hesitation dribble, driving attack, Tariq. Tariq made him miss the shot. Loose ball with 3, 2. Farquhar straight on 3, good look. Halfway down, it popped out. Rebound for Jarrett Culver of Texas Tech. 2 minutes left. We still have a media timeout coming. Moretti throws a missile in the right corner to Mooney. Moonswag backs out. Now it goes to Moretti. Left wing Culver playing catch around the perimeter. 1:48 left to play in the first half. What do we got?
I think they called an illegal screen at the top. It's a charge of some sort.
Moving screen.
And Chris Beard not happy. He's talking to referee Paul Jansen about it right now. I did not see who it was on.
It was on Tariq.
Yeah, at the top of the key right there. That's his second.
All right, media timeout, but just 1:47 left in the first half. Take a break.
Over Abilene Christian with 1:47 left to play in this first half.
And Jarrett Culver so far putting on a show. 17.7 of 8 from the field, 3 of 4 from the stripe. He's got 3 assists too, so he's sharing the ball as well.
Red Raiders come out with a 2-1-2 soft trap. Now they sink back in to a 2-3 zone. Corkrew was out of position, but now he's fine. Franklin passes to the right side for Peyton Ricks. They might shark out of this and go to a man. Instead, it's a turn fire short from the right block from Jaron Lewis, and Matt Mooney gets the rebound on the left side. Here he comes with 1:18 left to play in the first half. Tiptoeing, yo-yoing the left-hand bounce. Mooney picks it up, steps to his left, steps back right, finally bounces to Norris Odiasa. Chris Beard frustrated with this possession so far, with Tech leading by 12. 1:03 left to play as there's lob pass to Odiasse. Great up fake, and he gets fouled by Friday. That's Friday's third.
See, and that's why Coach Golding, he went with the gamble right there and left his big boy in there with two fouls, and you get a third with 1 minute left in the half, and that's
tough.
A gamble that did not pay off. Meanwhile, Tariq Owens with two fouls is sitting over there next to us.
Norris Odiasse will shoot a pair, and his first one is good. Norris playing in his 99th game as a Red Raider. He's made 84 starts. He's got 448 rebounds as a Red Raider. And this year, shooting 59% from the free throw stripe. It's up and good. Well, it's the Culver show, though. I mean, how many field goals do you have without Culver? Culver's hit 7 of your 13 baskets. 3 for Mooney, 2 for
Culver. 6 others. 7 made buckets by Culver, and then 6 others by others.
This is the largest lead level as Lennox is hot. He'll make another 3 in the left corner. Trey Lennox. Okay, he's hit 10 threes. 30% of them are in this first half.
Can't quite pull away from them because they keep burying threes. That's their fifth of the half.
38-27 Red Raiders with 34 seconds. Culver puts it on the deck, gets to the window, draws contact. Layup good. Count the basket. He's fouled again.
they can't guard him. He gets in the lane whenever he wants. He's got great body control, and he's continuing to finish at the rim. Now eight of nine with 19. Got a chance to have a 20-point first half if this free throw goes in here.
Culver has gone to 20 points eight times in his Red Raider career, four times this year, but I doubt he's ever done it in a half. There's 32.1 seconds left in this first half. Tech by 13, 40-27. Free throw is up, looks good. Hit the front, hit the backboard, and dropped in. He's got 20 points in the first half. 30 double-figure games, nine times 20 or more. 41-27, Red Raiders. Here comes Jalen Franklin with a slow bounce. There's only about 0.5 seconds difference between game and shot clocks. Franklin's just letting the clock whittle away. 9, 8 on the shot clock. At the top, he crosses to his right hand. Throws it out for Farquhar. 3 over Culver. An air ball. 3, 2. Corpru going to throw it up, I would hope. He does at the buzzer. Missed it short.
Well, and a bit of a hope shot right there by ACU. Didn't look great.
Yeah, it didn't. And then I thought Corpru was going to fire it much earlier.
Probably waited a little bit too long.
There was more space where he was coming across half court.
And you've got the officials over here looking at the replay. I don't know what they're looking for. The shot did not go in, so there's nothing to try to determine.
All right, we'll figure that out when we come back. These halftimes are short, so the AT&T halftime show starts next with the Red Raiders leading 41-27 at the break on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield. Jarrett Culver, who's packing 20 points with his number 23 on his back. Retro uniforms for both sides. There's a foul on Jalen Franklin, who had Culver really squeezed there. It looked like he had him hugged up.
Yeah, he was about to come off of a curl right there, right at the top of the key, and he was about to get points number 21 and 22 going to the bucket, and Mr. Franklin said, no, I think I need to
spend my second foul.
Yeah, exactly.
Moretti, Mooney, Owens, Odiasse, and Culver on the floor in white with the black numerals with 10, 9 on the shot clock. Moretti dancing right in front of Chris Beard, 7, 6. He's still outside the arc. Mooney, 4, 3, drives, throws it up high, too high. Missed alley-oop to Tariq Owens. That's hard to do, to throw it over that man. If there's a drive, a foul, and a miss on a shot for Peyton Ricks, but he'll shoot two after we pause for station identification. You're listening to Red Raider Basketball. Peyton Ricks makes the first of two free throws, an 87% free throw shooter on the year. The foul was on Davide Moretti, his second personal.
Then Hacks, that's the second time this game where Matt is just kind of, you know, just not quite made that lob pass like he wants it. It got tipped in the first half. That one right there, just an overthrow, and they're just trying to do anything they can to get Tariq going.
Both free throws good by Peyton Ricks as it's bounced to the top of the circle. Mooney trying to get open. There's a shot good on the left wing, a three for Davide Moretti.
Santa is coming to town. That's what we asked for.
Level.
That's what we asked for.
Wanted a Moretti shot to go in. I never saw it till it went through, but I trust that it was a three. Right wing Friday.
No lump of coal here.
Big down in the right corner. Franklin goes down to the block. A ball fake against the man-to-man for Lewis. Threw it out of bounds, but it was tapped that way by Moretti. Just 9 on the shot clock.
Yeah, 18, I think 43
left.
They're trying to figure out here, the Red Raiders are, exactly what ACU is going to run out of the out of bounds. But you're up 16, game in hand. No silly fouls.
Friday's pass whacked up in the air and taken by Matt Mooney. Mooney's got it all the way to the hole. Layup good with the right hand.
He's got another gear in the open floor. Absolutely. I don't think people realize that. It's sneaky athletic. When he hits another gear running downhill, man, look out.
Funnel pass down to the left block for Friday. A bullet one in the right corner for a three. And it missed short. It hit the front iron for Peyton Ricks. Rebound, Norris Odiasse in the lane for the Red Raiders. Here comes Jarrett Culver prancing into the front court. Can use a screen. Refuses it. On the right wing, 46-28. Tech largest lead. Matt Mooney hiding behind a screen. Had it knocked away for a moment. Got it back with 13 on the shot clock. Owens tried to hit a backdoor cutting Matt Mooney, and it ricocheted out of bounds along the baseline in the corner.
Yeah, T.O. had no chance to complete that pass. I think he just misread where the defender was going to be. They just really want to get Tariq going tonight. Just the 2 points, both made free throws right there. Yeah, he's got those early fouls.
Matt Mooney will throw it in to Tariq, back to Matt, drives it in, pitches right corner. Brandon Francis for three. Front rim and over, and it's ripped out of the air. The big right paw of Jelani Friday, who plays with three fouls.
Just can't get Francis to knock one down right now.
Franklin shoots the rainbow. He drove it in there, and falling away, went a mile in the air and plunged through perfectly. 46-30, Tech.
Francis 0-4 from the field.
Ready around Friday's hedge, picks up his bounce, needs some help, hands it off for Jarrett Culver. He wants space. Culver spins it for three. Bang! A guns up three ball. He's got 23.
I mean, he's just feeling it. That's about 3 foot from behind the arc right here in front of us. And 9 of 10 from the field is Jarrett Culver.
Is that good? There's a drive by Ricks. He's fouled by Mooney. And two foul shots coming for Peyton Ricks. Hey, you don't have to live in Lubbock to pursue your education through Texas Tech. With more than 100 bachelor, master's, and doctoral degrees and certificate programs fully online, you can achieve your goals. More information is available at elearning.ttu.edu.
Yeah, and I would say that Jarrett Culver is going to be sad to see the Coliseum court not be here anymore. He'd like a throwback game next year, although guess what? He may not be here to play in it.
Free throw good by Peyton Ricks. That was my silence. I just made a pause in mourning of that thought.
That's right. That's the reality of it. And it's because of nights like this, his game will certainly translate whenever he decides to make that decision.
Both free throws good by Ricks. He's got all 4 points for Abilene Christian in this second half. Moretti's going to drive. Falls away from the baseline. Yes, sir. Davide Moretti has 7 points, and that was smooth. Something changed at halftime for him. 51-32 Tech. Largest lead at 19. Baby Hook Friday rolled out from right to left. Rebound Jarrett Culver. Culver running into the front court. Crosses over. Takes it down the lane. Hangs up in the air. Got it to Francis for three. Halfway down and out. Boy, it's cold as ice. Cold as that 10 inches of snow we got back a couple of days ago as it's thrown out of bounds by Jalen Franklin. I don't think anybody in white touched it, but the official said Abilene Christian ball. Nobody touched it.
Well, and Hax, did you see though that Brandon paused? He paused before that shot went up, just almost like he's thinking about it too much. But you're right. Nobody touched it. The crowd is booing
because the ball's been awarded to Abilene Christian.
Yeah, and he basically just threw that into the crowd.
Yeah, he was out of control, and then I think he thought he got fouled.
Yeah, they just missed it.
Culver comes off for a breather. Mooney, Edwards, Odiase diving, gets it. Loose ball pass to Mooney. Mooney's got a man trailing, finds Edwards, layup good.
Nice unselfish play right there by Matt, and great body control. Kind of the double clutch right there by Kyler Edwards.
All starts with Norris Odiase diving on the floor, and that's what he can do, is get down there in the dirty areas of the floor and make a play. Friday's baby hook missed. Edwards runs with a rebound, leads Corprew into the corner. Well, he was looking up and kind of jostled the ball, so he picks it back up. Mooney wing right with 15:48 left of the ball game, Tech by 21. Mooney hesitates and got called for an offensive foul as third.
That was, that was Coach Beard right there. You may have heard that.
Coach Beard's not on the radio, but he's on the radio.
Yeah, that's right. Hitting the scores table right there. I think a little flustered right there was Coach Beard. And yeah, we're good.
We're recovered.
Yeah, we're 15:45 good.
15:45 left to play in this one here at the Coliseum. Texas Tech 53 and Abilene Christian 32 on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield. Up radio. Hey, don't forget to experience link style golf and superb playing conditions at the Rawls Golf Course at Texas Tech. The Rawls Course is open to the public, so book your tee time now by calling 806-742-4653. Jeff Haxton and Chris Level Accent Level on the radio with you. Maurice Jones back in Jeff City as we go back to work, right to left for the purple-clad Cats. And it says Cats across the front of the jersey tops. ACC down each side for Abilene Christian. Three on the left wing, off to the right. Missed by Ricks. Rebound for the Red Raiders. Edwards rifles one to Corporate, who tripped on the official, who went down very awkwardly. That looked like it was extremely painful. For a really nice guy we just talked to, Roderick Dixon, just went down, and it got hit on his heel, and he went down hard. Chris Williams, our head athletic trainer for basketball, is tending to Roderick Dixon. He's trying to get out of the way, trying to run past the action. And was it Edwards? No, Edwards.
Yes, it was Deshaun Corprew and Roderick Dixon. They just got tied up, and they were going in a big hurry here down the corner. And Roderick Dixon, he just went down. It looks like it's his right knee. And we were just having a really good conversation with him just not 2 minutes ago.
All right, help him up. Good.
Yeah, and that leg is awfully stiff. We'll see what.
Sean Sutton, Glenn Cyprian. John Riley all over there to.
I think he's just trying to check his faculties, make sure that he's.
Well, he went down so fast, you know, and you get hit, and he's not waiting. He can't react to that because he can't see it.
Yeah. And you could hear Chris Beard yelling, run! And Deshaun Corprew coming down this this court with a head of steam. And then Chris Beard and Roderick Dixon kind of share a hug right there. We may have to.
Chris Beard saying, let's give this guy a round of applause. That's awesome.
Yes.
Coach Beard, that's awesome. Waving to the fans to give him a round of applause because I think he's okay.
I think it may have just scared him more than anything.
He
went down. He went down hard.
Awkwardly now.
And I was just looking up to make sure everything was pointing in the right direction.
Right.
You know, it's one of those deals.
Unfortunately, those things can happen. Catching fire, Culver. Yes, sir. Jarrett Culver, just stay hot, young man. Boy, that was a great down screen that freed him up. He's got 25.
And that just hit all net. He's just feeling it tonight.
We had a battle underneath with Friday and Odiase, and Norris is going to pick up a foul, his first.
This is as clean of a game as I've seen a Tech player have in years to this point. I mean, just it's
squeaky.
Yes. I mean, there's just been no.
Foul on Norris Odiase. That is his second on the inbounds. Continue.
Well, and I don't know if I agree with the call of Norris, but anyway, it's just everything that Jared has done. It's in the flow of the offense. He's just shooting it very pure.
Rick's terrible three that was 3 feet strong. Grabbed by Corporu, who leads Culver, who gallops and dunks with the right hand. He flew off the left foot and powered it home for a career high 27.
And Corporu throws him a no-look over-the-shoulder pass. I mean, Culver is running down the floor. The ball goes over his shoulder, and he just lets it bounce in front of him, and he doesn't even look to catch it. And he just goes and hammers it in on the baseline with a dunk. And that, I'm telling you, this is salty right now. Enjoy it. If you're in a Tech position to see this kid for the rest of the year, man, I hope you enjoy him.
14:55 left, and it's taken as a full timeout. 57-32, Red Raiders rocking in the Coliseum. We'll take a break on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield. basketball playoff action. Scott is listening at Tyler, reminiscing on all his memories here at the bubble. Welcome back to the Coliseum. Fox Sports Southwest is serving up Red Raider basketball all season long. Be sure to tune in every Wednesday for Double T Insider, powered by Texas Tech TV. That's Hacks in level with you.
8-0 run, Hacks, over the last couple of minutes by the Red Raiders.
Having fun tonight. Career high 27 for Jarrett Colbert. There's a high screen. Running to the left is Franklin. Low dribble to the fingertips. Threw it right to Kyler Edwards, who knocked it to Jarrett Colbert. And here come the Red Raiders, being prodded to run by Chris Beard. Culver slides off a screen, blows to his right, got around Friday, jumped to pass it out left wing for Edwards. 14:25 left in this second half, Tech leading 57-32. Francis with his toe on the line, missed the long jumper, and a foul on the floor against Abilene Christian, I believe. Chris, do you see anything under there? It looked like it's going to go against P.J. Maxwell, his second.
Yeah, Kyler Edwards, he just pulled up for that shot right there, and not necessarily in the flow of the offense, but trying to initiate some offense. And that's what's fun about watching Culver right there penetrate. He penetrates and kicks it out, but then Texas Tech doesn't get sped up. They just go ahead and relax and work the shot clock a little bit. You end up with a wide-open jump shot by Kyler.
Culver with a step back, thought about the three. Maxwell guards him, puts a hand in his jersey and stole it from him. Culver just lost it. The only mistake he's made all night. There's a hard drive, a layup missed. A foul is Clay Gaiman, who's in for the first time from Nevada, Missouri. Regional dialect, Nevada, Missouri. Drew the foul, he'll shoot two.
Yeah, they get Culver on the foul right there, so you got the turnover, and he comes over here and says, he says to Coach Beard, my fault, Coach. Hey, you know what? I think he'd be, you know, Coach Beard's going to be okay with it.
Foul is, or the foul shot is up and strong for Gaiman, who's 5-for-7 from the line this season.
You answer this for me. Would you agree this is, you have a chance to put really two really good halves together. This is about as good as I've seen this bunch this year. I mean, we've seen it in spurts.
Let's see the last 14, but so far you're absolutely correct, as that one is strummed by Clay Gaiman. He's 1-for-2. And the Red Raiders take the rock back with 13:55 left to play in the second half, leading 57-33 here at the Coliseum on throwback night. There's a backdoor pass and a layup good by Matt Mooney. A dime drop by Culver.
I mean, just complete.
That's sick.
From Mr. Culver.
Thrown underneath and out of bounds. Oh, the Wildcats are in big trouble as Joe Pleasant fumbled it out of bounds. Odiase did a good job of holding his ground.
Yeah, Jarrett's going to come out of the game right now. Just 5 turnovers by the Red Raiders in this game. I want to continue to bring that up because you talk about 8 or less, 10 or less. And again, it hadn't always been that easy for this team. But tonight, they're really doing a good job of taking care of the basketball.
Culver checks out with his game high 27, career high 27. And that's a pass that's thrown out of bounds. Mooney threw it out in front of the cutter. Corprew, and it went right along the baseline, that basket support area, as it went out of bounds. Right to left in all purple with white trim and ACC down the side of the shorts. Abilene Christian. There's a strip by Kyler Edwards. He tried to dive there and get it, but couldn't. Gaiman threads the needle underneath. Jump stop, left corner. Up fake on the three by Lewis. His runner is good. Now that's the guy who's number one all time at Abilene Christian in D1 scoring. Well, they threw a pass near the official Roderick Dixon. It's like, I'm not doing this again.
He was kind of high-stepping, trying to get out of the way. You and I were watching the same thing. And that last turnover by Matt Mooney, his fourth. So we talked about that. 6 turnovers by the Red Raiders, 4 of those by Matt Mooney.
There's another one. Edwards fumbled it out of bounds as he was trying to come to a jump stop. It just kept going away from him and went out of bounds along the baseline. Are you going to take the blame for this?
Yeah, I feel like I'm just trying to compliment them on how clean that they had played and getting a little sloppy with it here in the last 3 or 4 possessions.
Dribble penetration for Jalen Franklin.
I'll take the hit on that, though.
Driving, jumps to pass right corner, 3 in the air. Good. That's Jalen Franklin who hits the 3. He's playing in his 98th game at Abilene Christian. One of the guys they say that will be a part of the story that turned the program from a D2 bottom feeder to a challenger in the Southland. They were not any good in D2. Now they're getting better and better. 59-38 Red Raiders, 12:05 left. Mooney, jets right, fumble it out of bounds.
12:02 left to play. That's three consecutive turnovers, and Mooney's got five of them. Timeout, Chris Beer.
Yeah, that category turned in a hurry. That's five turnovers by Matt Mooney. And very uncharacteristic.
You know coach will say, too, that's just discipline.
Yeah, it lack of focus, yeah. Things like that. Because, I mean, he's thrown a lob pass. He kind of airmailed it right there. He kind of goes and tries to just do it with the jump stop, and he's going to come up and just doesn't put the ball in both hands. It goes out of bounds. I mean, it's just the things like that. You know, just uncharacteristic.
12:02 left. We'll take a break. 59-38 Red Raiders over Abilene Christian on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield.
The Red Raiders have struggled taking care of the ball in recent minutes, but they're killing Abilene Christian on the glass tonight, 24-13. So you're plus 11 there. And, I mean, Abilene Christian comes into this game. They're pulling down 32 on average a game and out rebounding teams with a plus 4 margin.
Yeah.
They've had no look on the glass tonight at all, as Texas Tech has owned that department.
Yeah, the Red Raiders' athleticism and length have given Abilene Christian some problems. A little high-low action here at the top for Jaron Lewis, and he drains the 16-footer. Jaron Lewis averaging 15.2 points. He can go. 59-40 Texas Tech. We'll have that quick back-to-back timeout coming, so be aware of that. Tariq Owen starts to drive, backing in, throws it out to Corpru. Deshaun yo-yos with the left hand, hammering that dribble now with 11-10 on the shot clock. This is Davide Moretti staring at a man-to-man defense in purple. 5-4, hiding behind the back dribbles. 3, kicks it out. 2-1, Corpru missed the 3 strong as he got knocked into the first row of seats. Here come the Wildcats with Peyton Ricks. They'll set it up with 11:05 left. Wildcats won't have any quit in them. This is tossed out, foul line right, extended for Franklin. He'll release it out front. They're playing more fluidly here in the offense. Abilene Christian, now they got some difficulty. He passed it around Culver to the top. A couple of dribbles for Joe Pleasant. 7 on the shot clock. Tech leads by 19. Top of the key, hesitation drive. Tough shot up in the air, angle left. Short from Jalen Franklin. Punched up in the air and grabbed by Davide Moretti of Texas Tech. Yeah. Tech wants to run.
They are up and down the floor in a hurry. Back in a man-to-man set is Abilene Christian.
Owens tosses it under for Corpru, got called for the offensive foul. Corpru turns around and said, did I really do it? If I did it, I'll own it. If not, help me out. That's the first foul on Deshaun. Looked like he got the chair pulled on him pretty good.
Yeah, that's clearly, they baited him into that one. Certainly. John Stigliano with the call right there on Deshaun Corpru, and he just turned around and kind of, yeah, you hear Chris Beard basically
say. That's all he can do is flop.
Exactly. Can't guard him. Yeah, basically he's just saying
that's a great point.
They bailed him out.
That's all he can do is flop. That's when you know you've got some ownership of these guys, but you got to finish. 10-12 left is a lot of time. There's a drive, a block by Tariq, and he saved it into Brandon Francis. He swatted Jalen Franklin. Just now, Tariq getting up. He took a little bang as he got that block and saved, but he's fine. Brandon Francis, top of the key. Moretti steps in, turned down a couple of opportunities to shoot. Left corner long two, Tariq, yes sir. He brought rain or snow or sleet or whatever, but he drained it. 61-40 Red Raiders. 9:40 left to play in the second half, and there's an offensive foul on Friday, his fourth. He had that elbow just plowing backwards and got caught.
Yeah, I think that's, in a way, probably a bit of a makeup call. Same official was on the other end. That gets Corporu with the charge and Stigliano with the call on Friday right there is a bit ticky-tack. But again, that's if you're going to call it, you got to call on both ends.
Fouls for the teams, 7 for Tech, 3 for Abilene Christian. 63-40, Red Raiders. 9:30 left to play in the second half. Sliding over to the left side, Edwards finds Owens, who landed a little awkwardly and got fouled while he did it.
Yeah, I couldn't tell if he landed on somebody's foot or what, but you're right. He kind of hunkered down right there when he landed, and he's okay, though. Almost thought they may call him for a travel.
Yeah.
If he didn't land on somebody.
Like
he
landed on marbles almost.
Yeah.
Left corner three. Yes, sir! Jared Culver. He's got 30.
And it's just so pure. I mean, and Joe Golding is over here with his head on his forehead. He has no answer for Jared Culver.
Oh, Farquhar got up in the air, and Edwards went up with him, but Edwards is so strong that he caught himself like a cat, landing on his hands. That can't feel good, but he stopped himself and didn't get hurt. Foul on Kyler.
Yeah, this is a career night that we're watching from Mr. Jared Culver. 12 of 13 from the field, 30 points.
It's unfair.
2 of 3 from behind the arc, 4 of 5 at the stripes, 6 boards, 4 assists.
Farquhar's front end is missed.
There's another rebound.
Yeah, just allow him to do whatever. I mean, talk about stuffing the stat sheet. That is what Jared Culver is doing. Davide Moretti running around the hedge, sidearms to Owens. Good movement. Edwards, left wing, pushes it up for three. Bang! A guns up 3-ball for Kyler Edwards, his second of the night.
Boy, the ball didn't stick. It got passed around right there in the flow of the offense. Kyler just buried that one. That's fun to watch. See, and Francis will start doing that too. Look out, because this team can hit you from all different kinds of ways.
Yeah, you won't be able to guard everybody, will you? Farquhar almost threw it away. It went off of Davide Moretti's fingertips with 8:34 left to play in the second half. And this high-ceilinged building, the old bubble, has still a full house inside of it as Mooney checks in for Kyler Edwards. Nope, Jared Culver. JC going to get a big round of applause.
I feel like I need to stand and clap right there.
Fran Fraschilla is behind you. He can do it for you. Ricks rips off the screen to the top. 10 on the shot clock for the Wildcats. Little hesitation floater. Air ball thrown up on the way down by Lewis. Good try, but he missed it. Kyler Edwards wearing the white headband. Patrols into the front court. Plows off the screen to the top. Now lets everybody cut through. 8:10 left to play in the ball game. Post entry pass knocked away, but a foul.
We need to ask about the headband because Tariq Owens didn't wear one the other night.
Yeah, he was headbandless for Northwestern State.
Northwestern State, yeah, the other purple team.
I was thumbing my way through the Southland that we've played. Right corner Edwards, up fakes, into the lane, throws it back for Norentz. He'll dunk it! Rip down that rim, big fella. Norentz Odiasse for 2.
And I tell you what, Chris Beard absolutely loves that. He's about to give Kyler Edwards a big old hug because some of the other guards on his team not doing what he wants, but Kyler Edwards made the right play right there and gets the big boy a dunk. Even Chris Williams just walks over here and is like, gives us a fist pump.
He's been fired up tonight. This yes. team is trying to be special again. When not many said that they could do it again, they're trying to be special again. Ranked 11th in the country and on their way to 10-0, I'd say they're doing a pretty good job of chasing that.
And we're about to see Gerald Myers introduced here. at midcourt, and Gerald Myers called this place home for about 20 years as head coach, and he deserves quite the ovation.
69-40, we'll step away. 8:01 left on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield.
Properties. Go to texastech.com and click on the Hotel Partners button. Our preferred properties are the Overton Hotel and Conference Center, MCM Elegante, Hyatt Place, Marriott Properties of Lubbock, and My Place Hotel. 69-40, Red Raiders over Abilene Christian. And we're under 8. In front of Joe Golding, the head coach for Abilene Christian, patrolling is Damian Daniels, the diminutive 5'7 reserve point guard. We didn't hear much from Lennox in the second half as he canned 3 shots. 10 on the shot clock for Daniels. Thrown back out to him at 5. He's straight on with Moretti. Given padding. Right corner, far court. 2-1. Just a desperation hope shot. Air ball and a shot clock violation. Red Raiders get the stop. Ondigo will check in for Norrence Odiasse.
Yeah, you finally go 9 deep. And Coach Golding puts Friday back into the game, so that's Malik's going to have to deal with their starting center.
Edwards, Mooney, Ondigo, Moretti, and Owens on the floor in white as there's a pass that's deflected out of bounds. Peyton Ricks ran through it and swatted it to one of the fans over there in that row where the chairs are much more padded than the ones we sit in level.
Yeah, I would say so.
We're not at that donor level like them.
Yeah.
Owens rips his elbows through and then had his pass knocked out of bounds by Peyton Ricks again. Who's Mr. in everybody's way. That's 2 times that he's interrupted the possession on this trip. Tyler Edwards waiting on a screen. Jogs to his left. Elevates from 17. Yes, sir. Tyler Edwards. He is going to be something else.
Again, he can play the point, he can play off the ball a little bit, but when he starts burying shots like that, because he's got 10 points now, 4 or 6 from the field, look out.
Friday misses the baby hook, and it's tipped by Friday right to Matt Mooney. Don't forget, Abilene Christian's 9-1. Their only loss was on the road at Pepperdine. 6:40 left to play in the Coliseum's basketball history. 71-40, Red Raiders, lob pass to Edwards. Edwards up fakes, then tried to go up strong, but no foul. That's a good call. Friday stoned him there at the rim.
And you know, I was looking at, you know, you look at their wins and losses, and you know, I thought of the name Michael Oluwakandi. Remember him?
Yes.
Candyman, because they beat Pacific by a couple of points. I believe that was Oluwakandi's alma mater.
A wild left-hand shot missed by Abilene Christian. A foul, though, on Malik Ondigo. That'll be his first. Malik playing in his 24th game as a Red Raider. Only has 13 career baskets. 2 free throws for Jelani Friday. Friday playing in his 68th game in an ACU uniform. 914 points entering today. Hit 2 early threes. He's got 10 points, so 9 24 in his career. Friday, certainly a guy that could play anywhere as he misses the front end of the 1-1. He's a junior from Oklahoma City and Level. He was a homeschool guy, found his way down to Abilene. That's a nice pickup for Coach Golding.
I don't think I could have handled homeschool very well. Not enough discipline in the Level household for me to be able to pull that off. Matt Mooney with a nice jump shot right there. Now into double figures as well.
Mooney looked like he was playing horse on that one. He just jumped up and knocked it in. He's got six double figure games this year. Friday banging in, spins to the right shoulder with the left hand and got fouled by Tariq Owens. That'll be Tariq's third with 5:44 left.
Yeah, and ACU has not scored in 5:51, and they're 0 of their last 8. Meanwhile, the Red Raiders are 6 of their last 7.
So, gets you some separation, won't it?
Yeah, hence the 33-point lead here by Texas Tech.
73-40, Red Raiders. Friday. Back rim of that one. Friday, he's better than this Level. He's an 86% free throw shooter coming in, 19 of 22. In Brick City for him today. He's 0 for 2, now 1 for 3. Iverson in motion. 73-41 after the 1 for 2 trip by Jelani Friday. Matt Mooney throws a bounce pass and a foul against ACU. That was Kyler Edwards who got pushed.
And Coach Golding, hands on hips right now, just not many answers. Is again, this is his, this is one of the best games we've seen the Red Raiders put together so far, led by Jarrett Culver's 30 points.
Mooney, foul line left extended beyond the arc, ball in his right hip pocket. Little juke gets him free, but then tracking back to get him, Damian Daniels. Owens straight on with 7, gonna arc it up for 3. Yes, sir! Tariq Owens knocks in his second 3 of the season.
Not working on the baseline dunks tonight, but he's sure feeling it from the perimeter.
Boy, he threw that thing high in the air.
Yes,
such
he did.
Soft touch. 5:05 left, Red Raiders 76-41, largest lead at 35 points. We're going to get Andrew Sorrells in at the next dead ball.
And so the Red Raiders are in the midst of a 17-1 run right now.
Left wing after a missed 3, getting an offensive rebound, Jalen Franklin. Franklin pounding the dribble, goes to Jelani Prati, who ball fakes at the man-to-man, funnels a pass down to the right block, back to the basket for Lewis, faces up, quick shot, missed it over on Digo. And Tariq Owens going to his back, had it, but lost it. And then he got back up to get the rebound, but a foul on Malik Gondigo.
It's a good foul right there by Malik. Make him earn it. Just a little loose with the basketball there underneath.
Don't forget to let us know where you're listening in from tonight to the final game in the Coliseum at Guns Up Radio. The way to do that. Shot up, no good by Friday. Missed it strong. Say hello to Justin, who writes in. He says they'll be at Madison Square Garden next Thursday night. Sold out, MSG.
Yeah, and I don't know how many Red Raider fans will be there, but I can guarantee you this. There'll be a couple of thousand there at least. So many people that we know headed up there for that one. It should be just, and it's a fun opportunity is what it is. It's not a NCAA tournament game. It's not a...
Not do or die.
No, not at all. It's just a fun
not
opportunity. Yeah, and you know what? The pressure will be on the opposition that night, not you.
Texas Tech going to remain undefeated. It's going to be 45 wins in a row over non-conference competition. Chris Beard's never coached a loss at home to a non-conference opposition. Really defended the home court well, whether it be at the Coliseum or the USA. Andrew Sorrells is in. One of the free throws was good on the other end. Brandon Francis got clocked as he went through the lane. It'll be team foul 7 and a 1-1.
And part of it is because, and you see the preparation that goes into these games, it's because they prepare for Savannah State or Abilene Christian or Northwestern State just like it's Villanova or Kansas or Texas. This is just the difference in Chris Beard and his guys that he's got working with him is just constant grind and constant preparation. I mean, they take it very seriously. There's just no, opportunity for a slip-up typically just because they just are so well prepared.
Well, and then this is the ultimate trap game, right?
Yes, it is. Yeah, throwback.
Didn't play like it.
throwback look ahead because of the holidays and the trip to New York and all those things, but
brought some focus tonight. Brandon Francis hits a badly needed free throw. By the way, Jelani Friday is fouled out. It's his second foul out of the year. He shook everyone's hand. He shook his teammates' hands and then the referees and headed for the bench as the free throw is good. 2 for 2 for Brandon Francis in his 47th game as a Red Raider. 78-42 Tech.
Thanks.
Lewis lobbed in. Catch and face for Joe Pleasant, who spins wildly to his right shoulder, missed it with a left hand. Horford tapped it down to Kyler Edwards with 4 minutes left. The Red Raiders lead big, 78-42, and set it up on offense. Chris Beard, you probably heard him say he wants 4 passes. Francis, cupped on his right hip, baseballs it to Sorrells. Sorrells back to the right wing for Francis. 3:45 left as Francis jets right baseline. Left hand layup missed, angling right. Got his own miss, airballed the putback, and it went out of bounds off of ACU. Final media timeout, 3:39 left to play here at the Coliseum. We'll take a break. Texas Tech 78, Abilene Christian 42 on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield.
Last 6 minutes or so, again, if you've missed it, and my man Hacks has mentioned it a dozen times in the last half hour at least, but Jarrett Culver with 30 points, 12 of 13 from the field, 7 rebounds, 4 assists. I'd say December the 15th was pretty good to my man JC there, number 23, having a career night for himself in what's going to be Texas Tech's 10th victory of the season.
That rebound high is going to be tough for him to get level. He got 12 boards at number 20 West Virginia as Ondigo gets a layup. The assist from Brandon Francis. 12 boards, that's a lot.
Yes, it is.
Did you think you'd have Abilene Christian almost doubled up with 3:20 left?
No, this is not something I envisioned. You know, I feel weird because you kind of – you get asked about around town, like, hey, man, is Abilene Christian any good? Is Texas Tech going to kill them? And you kind of talk up these other opponents. We get to studying them and scouting them and kind of trying to get a feel for who teams are. And then Texas Tech just keeps putting these teams away.
Damian Daniels missed a three on the other end as Kyler Edwards fires it out to Ondigo. Shot fake, right side Sorrells. Ondigo for three. Shorten off to the left. Ondigo's tried a couple of those this year. He's 0 for 5. From three-point range. 2:47 left in the Coliseum in this throwback game. Parker Hicks and Avery Benson are going to check in. Shot blocked underneath by Malik. Oh, he swatted Jaron Lewis. Corper is running, crossing over into the lane. He got swatted. And now Mbala, Benson, and Hicks will all check in. Edwards, Corpru. Who else? Who else headed out?
I couldn't tell either.
You know, one thing we haven't brought up is Mr. McCullough sitting down there.
Yes, he is, and people may not.
Mr. Kayvon Moore is sitting
down there. People may not realize who Kevin McCullough even is, but you will now see another long, lanky, 6'5", 6'6".
It's just amazing how these guys look.
Yeah, really good player on a Red Raider, in a Red Raider uniform, although he's not suited out tonight.
Mbala got fouled on a putback attempt. Josh will shoot two. He's played 32 total minutes this year, but he's appearing in his ninth game.
Yeah, and you've got, you know, with McCullough, he is somebody that just showed up on campus yesterday. He is eligible to play right away if Texas Tech wants to go that route. Can imagine that anything like that would happen very soon, just because he hasn't been through any practices or any sort of offseason. He didn't even know where to go in the different drills during shoot around today or anything like that.
I mean, there's a lot of info. There's a lot of data that goes into being a player at Tech. Zimbala had that one roll around and miss. He went 1-for-2. That's his first free throw as a Red Raider that went in. 81-42, Texas Tech. What an unbelievable result here. You've more than doubled up what you were supposed to win this game by, if you look at those things, as the three is cast up and bounces short for Chase Cobb, a 6'1 reserve guard from Richmond, Texas, Faith West Academy.
And I'm just going to say it. I'm going to put my money on Andrew Sorrells as the person that makes the last bucket in this building. You got a pony you want to put your money on?
I'll take Hicks.
Okay, Hicks. Okay, there we go.
The only reason is this free throw is up and good from Tobias Cameron, who's appearing in his 10th game, but doesn't get a whole lot of time when the game is in doubt. Hicks has 2 points in this house already.
Yeah, he does.
He got two against Rice last year, so that's where I'll go.
I have a little inside info there. Is he's dealing with a little strep throat, so he's not feeling up to... feeling like himself, so we'll see if that affects him in the last about a minute and a half here.
Malik Ambigo outside the arc left to Avery Benson, who's had the haircut. There's a three by Hicks. Front rim and bounced off the backboard. Had a foul against Texas Tech. We'll stop the clock with a 1:38 left.
He had it dialed in, Hacks. Oh. I was about to go to the old wallet. We got a 1:38 left, though, so there's still some time for somebody, but he missed it.
Got a free throws happening on the other end. Red Raider fans support the preferred restaurants that support the Red Raiders. Go to TexasTech.com and click on the restaurant partners button. 50th Street Caboose, Fuddruckers, Blue Sky, Rudy's Barbecue, Walk-On's Bistro and Bar, and Texas Taco Company, the Texas Tech preferred restaurants. Free throw missed short by Chase Cobb. He'll have another one coming. Free throw is up, and it's good.
That's Coach Beard talking to our man Colin right there.
He's just 2 days removed from a birthday.
Yeah.
He's had a good week. Shaking his head, Chase is. No, Colin is. Chase is agreeing with you as well. There's a running layup that missed by Avery Benson. He got fouled. AB will shoot two with 1:26 left.
Avery Benson with a couple of free throw attempts right here. We didn't put any money on our man AB. We don't need to tell him that.
Free throw strong.
Okay, we jinxed him all.
This is a big thing, though. For these guys to have that and know that once this game is over, that they
that's
can
it.
Put it in their pocket for the rest of time.
That's right.
That's pretty cool.
Because, I mean, you had our man, and he missed the second one. Well, you had our man, Jarrett Culver, channeling his inner Chauncey Billups. I think that the last game it was in here, 99.
Dude, he looked like Chauncey Billups.
Yeah, yeah. I think Billups went for 90. I think he went for 44 points that night.
Wow. There's a putback good by Abilene Christian. They were getting after it underneath. 1:05 left to play in this one. Texas Tech leads 81 to 47. There's so many people that would pay good money for one of the chair backs in this house. You could have the last points as a Red Raider if you get something done here. But it's looking a little rough as Mbala goes out to Hicks. 10 on the shot clock. Threw it off the foot of Ondigo. Flipped it to Josh. Mbala missed it, but he's fouled, and he'll shoot two.
6 seconds on the shot clock right there. Nobody wants to pull the trigger on shooting it, and the free throws won't fall in. As I look across the court right here, I see Mr. and Mrs. Culver sitting there in about the third row, and boy, don't you know that they'll have these memories for a long, long time as we talk about last points. But I mean, to see their son, you know, having a game like this in a building, which this is the last basketball game, that's got to be a lot of fun too.
Mbala goes 1 for 2. He got one to drop in. It might be Josh, because you're in dribble it out territory now.
Joshua,
with the final Joshua
Mbala was the lead horse.
It might be him. There's 13 seconds between game and shot clocks. Red Raiders lead at 82 to 47.
We need a steal here.
There's a floater that missed short by Cameron Tobias, and a foul against Texas Tech. Looks like it'll stay on that end to our left. Foul on Parker Hicks, the sophomore from Decatur. Texas Tech taking the winning streak to 45 straight over non-conference competition. It started all the way back on December 30th, 2013. Is that one missed strong? The last non-conference opponent to win in Lubbock. LSU in a bloodbath. That's what Clark Lambert tells me anyway. Free throw good. 26 seconds left. The Red Raiders can dribble it out if they choose. 82-48, Red Raiders. Across the timeline, altering hands with the bounce. It's Avery Benson from Springdale, Arkansas. 12, he's going to blow by one defender. I think Coach Beard just said no shots. 8, 7, 6. Well, to the Coliseum, thanks for the memories. The Red Raiders win 82-48 over Abilene Christian and stay undefeated at 10-0.
Yeah, that was a special night. That was a special night right there, 82-48. And it was Jarrett Culver's night. It was Texas Tech's night. You played pretty clean basketball. It's one of the best 40-minute games, and maybe the best one that we had seen from this team all season long, as you get to 10-0. And that's not happened many times in this program's history either. But, Hacks, this was a lot of fun to sit next to you and sit next to our man Colin and call this one, because we won't forget Jarrett Culver's evening anytime soon.
Just some chill bumps there sent up my spine with the Raider power chant. And, boy, it was good stuff here tonight. Our Gators Bayou Cajun Grill and Bar postgame show comes your way next on the Texas Tech Sports Network from Learfield.